wrestling world was shocked because Barry Windham has returned to the Horsemen as one of the original four. I pride myself on the friends that I keep. But this week, right here on NWA Pro, we have the biggest shock of all because the Horsemen are going to dominate professional wrestling in 1990.
This portion of the NWA Pro is brought to you in part by the makers of A&W. Try an A&W root beer or cream soda. There's just more to it. And by the Nintendo Entertainment System. Nintendo, now you're playing with power. And by Rouge, shoes for your feet, pockets for your stuff. Hello again, everybody. This is Lance Russell for the Fabulous Freebirds, Michael PSAs, and Jimmy Jam Garvin. And let me tell you today, later on, guys, a big surprise announcement from the Horsemen.
Wait just a minute, Lance, baby. We told you last week that Michael and I knew about the surprise all along, man. I mean, come
on. Look, we hired you to announce, so ladies and gentlemen, the guy that we've hired, take it away, Lance Russell.
We're going to see, in addition to the big announcement by the Horsemen today, we'll be looking at Doom in action. Also, Gordon Soley on the Wrestling Wrap-Up will be talking about the situation with the Horsemen, Luger and Flair from last week. There will be special comments coming from Sting. You'll see the United States Tag Team Champions, Flying Brian and Seaman, and our feature matchup will be Animal going against Mean Mark. Right now, let's go to the ring.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is a tag team event. Making their way toward the ring, the United States Tag Team Champions. First from Minneapolis, Minnesota, 251 pounds, the Z-Man. His tag team partner from Cincinnati, Ohio, 226 pounds,
to see the United States Tag Team Champions in the ring. Let's listen to some words from Jimmy Cornette.
Pillman and Zink, you think you found the perfect way to humiliate me by sticking me in a little cage like some kind of stinking animal at Capital Combat. Well, let's see who's going to be humiliated, who's going to be embarrassed, who's going to be ashamed of themselves when the Midnight Express proves they can beat you with me or without me.
Here we go, starting it out with Galaxian number one as they're off and running in the action against the Z-Man and Flying Brian. And of course, Cornette has got some personal interest in the action of Z-Man and Flying Brian. He has that match coming up with the Express where Cornette is going to be in a cage at Capital Combat 90, the return of World War Cop.
Well, I'm going to tell you what, everybody's talking about Capital Combat 90, return of RoboCop. Flying high, flying drop kick. The thing is, do you really think, now think about it from this point of view, that without Jim Cornette, the Midnight Express would be unable to win any match or even this title match? I mean, the guys are self-motivating wrestlers in themselves. Cornette guides them, but I don't think that they're helpless without him.
Well, nobody said that they're helpless without him.
Well, you did.
No, I did not. What I got to tell you is you tell me that Cornette hadn't interfered in a lot of matches and made it possible for him to win. I know it has, and it's going to make Z-Man and Brian feel a lot better with him in that cage.
Let me tell you something, Lance. You're the one that's a little bit too nosy. You know, you try to stick your nose in other people's business, and the fact is, every time I look at Flying Brian and Z-Man, I just about get sick. Don't you, Michael? I mean, really,
that goes without saying. But the point I'm trying to make, nice drop kick there. These kids are high flyers. They're always on the move, and they've been very successful so far. But when the pressure of the big pay-per-view, there in Washington, D.C., there in our nation's capital, will they be able to live up to the pressure then?
Well, that's obviously why we're going to have the match, but I still say they're going to feel better with Cornette caged up there. Speaking of tag matches, at this coming Saturday when we come up with the Capital Combat 90, the return of RoboCop. What a shot coming from Flying Brian. Catapulted into the ring.
Double team.
Bruises call. Two, three. Ended up, and they got themselves a win by a teamwork combination.
Here are your winners, the United States Tag Team Champions, Flying Brian and the Z-Man.
There it is, a victory for Z and Brian Bryan as we take a look at it.
Here it is, well set up. Drop kick, disc did glaze off the shoulder, but Z-Man goes outside. Pillman comes for the slingshot and a high impact to the body press, 6 feet up in the air, gives him the 1-2-3.
Hooray, there's the victory, and right now it's time for us to take a look at the A&W King of the Slams. This week's candidate for the A&W King of the Slam, Mean Mark. And at 6 feet, 9 inches tall, there's no question there's plenty of height to deliver some awesome slam. If you think this is the King of the Slam, vote yes. 1-900-720-6051. If you don't, vote no. 1-900-720-6052. A&W, there's just more to it.
World's greatest float maker will now demonstrate how to make an A&W root beer float. First, the ice cream. Next, the rich, creamy A&W root beer. Now his assistant will make an equally delicious A&W cream soda float. The ice cream. The A&W cream soda. An A&W float is a great treat for you, your family, or a flock of friends.
Making life a little sweeter.
Life can stay a while.
Making dreams a little truer. Life a little sweeter. Mars.
No more big, crummy muffins. Because Hostess has created mini muffins. They're bite-sized, and Hostess bakes them with real fruit and nuts. They're moist and yummy, not big and crummy. Mini muffins from the Hostess Breakfast Bake Shop.
Attention stereo and electronics consumers. Major manufacturers and distressful distributors are desperate for cash.
Sell it!
Name brands like Alpine, Kenwood, Sony, Pioneer, Yamaha, JVC. Prices have been drastically cut. Up to 80%. CD players under $100. 100-watt subwoofer from $10 each. 100-watt kicker-type boxes from $99. Home speakers from $10 each. Cordless phones from $44. 120-watt power amp was $169, now $38. All merchandise fully warranted. No reasonable offer refused.
Sunday on WPTT's Weekend Cinema Showcase at noon, John Travolta gets down as he struggles to get into a Broadway musical in Stayin' Alive. Then, from a legacy of crime, they built an empire of power. Al Pacino, Robert De Niro, Diane Keaton, and Robert Duvall star in Francis Ford Coppola's compelling masterpiece, The Godfather Part 2. See it in its entirety, Sunday afternoon beginning at 2, only on WPTT-TV, Pittsburgh's 22.
Next time on an all-new episode of Star Trek, The Next Generation.
What am I doing here?
Commander Data is held hostage by powerful aliens.
If I help you escape, will you take me with you?
Will he break free and survive his capture? Or will he face death trying to escape?
No life signs.
Find out on the next all-new episode of Star Trek, The Next Generation.
Tonight at 7 on WPTT-TV.
Hello, everyone. This week's wrestling wrap-up concerns the total package Lex Luger. It was just a week ago on Worldwide Wrestling that Lex Luger announced to the wrestling world that he was going to defend his title, the U.S. title, against Dutch Mantell, even though in just 3 weeks he has a World Heavyweight Championship match with Ric Flair, the Capital Combat 90, the return of RoboCop. Well, Luger also said he had a special surprise for everybody. Let's listen to his comments right now.
I never thought I'd thank somebody for slapping me in the face, but for one time I will. I want to thank him right here on national TV. I want to bring Sting out here right now.
All right.
Unreal. And speaking of unreal, the last time I got to stand next to the total package live and in color was at Greensboro, and I was glad to be at ringside. I liked it so much being at ringside, but today I'm gonna do it again when he wrestles for the U.S. title one more time. Woo!
Well, not only was Sting a surprise, but Ole Anderson himself had a surprise for everybody. Later on in the hour, Ole Anderson came to the microphone and made this blockbuster of an announcement. Let's listen to Ole.
What are you leading up to here? It's not going to be Dutch Mantell here on the program this week.
Luger, I tell you what, you right now are going to be looking at the worst nightmare, the worst dream you've ever seen. Instead of Mantell, I bought that contract. You're going to be looking at none other than Rick, the world heavyweight champion, Flair.
Obviously, the stage was set for an electrifying impromptu match between Lex Luger and Ric Flair. And it was the only purpose of the Horseman was to hurt Lex Luger. Let's take a look.
He chops Luger in the chest.
Well, with the return of Barry Windham as one of the Horsemen, it certainly changes the weight of this situation in favor of the Horsemen. Obviously, the Horsemen are prepared for RoboCop and Sting. They're prepared for Lex Luger and his quest for the World Heavyweight Championship. But here's what an irate Lex Luger had to say.
What you've done, Ric Flair, what you've just seen, is you formulated the final chapter between you and I. And when I say that, what I mean by that, Ric Flair, is this. For 2 years now, I've chased you. I've hounded you. You've run. You've begged. And Ric Flair, most of all, you've had J.J. Dillon, Tully Blanchard, Barry Windham. It goes all down the line to Ole Anderson, to woman. It never ends. You think you sprung a surprise on me, but Ric Flair, you think you're up here. But the fall is going to be tremendous in Capital Combat, because all you've done is fan the flames. All you've done, Ric Flair, is give me the ultimate motivation. Because Ric Flair, I feel it from everybody out there across the country. They're not big fans of Lex Luger. What they do know and what they do feel is the tide has turned. The momentum is gaining. It's gaining. And Lex Luger is on the brink. And now comes Capital Combat. In a steel cage, Ric Flair. No outs interference. You me man to man. And if I don't beat you in this match, Ric Flair, I will never ask for a title match again from you the rest of my career. That's how confident I am that I'm going to win in Capital Combat.
Lex, what happened to you could very well happen again. You best beware and be prepared to be beaten.
That's the bottom line. Be prepared to
to be humiliated. Be prepared to be stitched up. Be prepared to be put in a calf. Be prepared to get hurt. Because Luger, Capital Combat 90, the cage goes up. The level of intensity becomes so overwhelming that it takes a man like Ric Flair. It takes a person the quality of woman to handle this big time wrestling action. Wrestling action, Ric Flair. Think about it. For 9 years, your world heavyweight champion. For 9 years, there isn't a man that walked into this sport who I didn't beat half to death if I had to keep that title. So Luger, Washington, D.C., the cage goes up. Blood, you want that? Sweat, and the pain of defeat. Think about it. You're going to feel all three at the hands of Ric Flair. Woo!
Capital Combat 90, the return of RoboCop is only a week away. And only time will tell if the Horseman can stop Lex Luger in his quest for the World Heavyweight Championship. I'm Gordon Solie, and reminding you for an in-depth look at the NWA, get your copy of the NWA Wrestling Wrap-Up on sale at events around the world.
World Championship Wrestling's coming to Pittsburgh, Colombo Center, Friday, June 1st, 8 o'clock, a break night. The NWA World Championship, Lex Luger clashing with Nature Boy, Ric Flair. The Road Warriors take on Doom, Rick Steiner versus Barry Windham. Norman clashes with Bam Bam Bigelow. Plus an all-star card, Friday, June 1st at 8. Ticket information at the box office and the Colombo Center outlet. Yes, World Championship Wrestling in Pittsburgh.
Today's small cars are tougher than ever on oil. Their high-compression engines not only rev high, they can run hotter than regular small car engines. Their searing heat can begin to break down an oil immediately. That's why there's Castrol.
The motor oil that in every grade provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown.
So use Castrol before your engine does something to get you heated up. Castrol, engineered for today's smaller cars.
Battle ball. The name says it all.
Attention stereo and electronics consumers. Major manufacturers and distressful distributors are desperate for cash.
Sell it!
Name brands like Alpine, Pile Driver, Infiniti, Clifford, Techniques, Kenwood. Prices have been drastically cut. Up to 80%. 20-band home equalizer from $69. DJ speakers from $79. 120-watt power amps for $38. 100-watt subwoofers from $10 each. Receivers from $89. Mics, headphones, telephones from $5. All merchandise, fully warranty. No reasonable offer refused.
A veteran photographer with one last shot at the big time.
Halloween issue, key layout.
Do you still have the touch?
Razor sharp.
But high fashion demands a cutting edge.
You want to make her scream?
Yes.
So an expert gets into the picture.
Hey, babe!
But who will pay the high cost for Freddy's services?
Keep the motivation, Kiki. It's wonderful.
A special Halloween treat on Freddy's Nightmares.
Tonight at midnight on WPTT-TV.
Next week on WPTT's 8 o'clock movies, Monday, William Shatner and Leonard Nimoy star in Star Trek The Motion Picture. Tuesday, Chuck Norris is driven by revenge in Forced Vengeance. Wednesday, Kirk Cameron and Dudley Moore star in the wacky comedy Like Father, Like Son. Thursday, Tom Skerritt strikes out against crime in Fighting Back. And Friday, Jan Michael Vincent takes on a vicious street gang in Defiance. Tune in for the 8 o'clock movies next week on WPTT-TV, Pittsburgh's 22.
Horseman, you said you were gonna take me out.
But you made a big mistake when you started messing with the little stingers.
So before you make your next move...
Think it over, creep.
Saturday, May 19th, Turner Home Entertainment strikes a blow for justice. Capital Combat 90, the return of RoboCop. The Honorable Ric Flair holds court in the ring when he defends his world heavyweight title against the mighty power of the total package, Lex Luger. The Steiners steal their own brand of law and order when they defend their world tag title against Doom. Norman and the Road Warriors take on tough guys at a six-man tag team rumble. A night of fight and metal.
Peace, officer.
Capital Combat 90, the return of RoboCop.
The following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Making their way toward the ring, Theodore Armand presents Ron Simmons, Betrayed, the King of Doom. Their opponents in the ring, for the combined weight 457, the team of Dave Diamond and Johnny Gunn.
What a powerhouse team this Doom is. If anybody has the physical attributes, they sure as Sam Hill to have them.
Well, there's no doubt about that, Lance. These are my guys. I'm a big Doom fan, and Butch Reed and Ron Simmons are bad boys, and I think they're going to take the titles away from the Steiners in Capital Combat 90, Return of RoboCop.
And that's just a week away. Just a week away. You can feel the fever pitch, and wait till you find out the surprise that the Horsemen have. I mean, Barry Windham, if that wasn't surprise enough.
That was a surprise.
The Horsemen, I'm telling you, we know the surprise. Uh-huh. This is going to floor you. Now they're going to be unstoppable. And I also heard they're going to be on the 900 number the night, if I'm not mistaken, May 19th at 6:45, where the fans can call in, right, and talk right to them live.
Exactly, Michael.
Of course,
Michael.
They won't do that because they ain't got the guts to tell them what they say behind their back.
Oh, well, we'll just find out. They're going to have the opportunity to give them a call and say anything they want and ask them any kind of
they
question.
They can say anything now.
And it'll be, that's...
Now, if you're lying, we're going to hold you up to this because
hey,
you know
if
how
I'm
you can.
Lying,
yeah, if you're
lying. A couple of guys to be talking about lying. Listen, you think we're going to get through this day without having a word or two about that corporal punishment match that you guys have got coming up in just a week right there in Washington. You got those straps and you got also the Rock and Roll Express who will have straps, not just the Fabulous Freebird.
Yeah, but the only difference is, Lance, baby, is we already know what's going to happen. We know what we're going to do. That's the difference that separates the men from the boys, Lance. That's right, and that's what's going to separate the Steiners and Doom. I'm telling you, a week from tonight, you're going to see them as the first, if I'm not mistaken, the first black world tag team champions.
Well, you know,
I know the record books. I know the rules.
I know, Michael. We respect your knowledge. You can make any prediction you want. Everybody's entitled to them. Butch Reed stands him up. Big suplex and down in the center of the ring. The opposition is Johnny Gunn and Dave Diamond going against the team of Doom. And, of course, there is Sugar Ray, Teddy Long.
And he's going to be victorious.
Oh, he's going to be.
Paul Heller, yeah, and I'm going to sit there. I'm taking my camera. I want to see pictures of Paul Heller getting that head shape.
You and I may have a little talk after this is over, and we'll see about putting up and shutting up one of the two in there, because I'm interested in that match.
Lance,
I can't wait for Ellering to get our crack.
We all have a talk. It's going to take more than just a little bit of time. Good high knee.
Big knee coming up from Butch Reed, and there's the tag on Ron Simmons, and if it's possible, Simmons even bigger than Butch Reed. They are doing some kind of work together.
Whoa!
Big snap and smash as he pounded him down into the mat. And look at the bulk on that Ron Simmons. But when they get in there with the Steiners, they're going to be in there against somebody a little bit bigger than Johnny Gunn and David Diamond. You see it happen as Butch Reed covers one, two, three, and there you have it.
Here are your winners, the team of Ron Simmons, Butch Reed, the team of Doom.
Right now, Doom has racked up another one in there as they have come through with a victory, and I got to tell you, they're setting it up. Let's take a look at the slow-mo.
Well, here you see him. He's hitting the ropes and coming off with some serious impact. What a clothesline. These guys work great as a team. They're wrestling machines. They're going to do great against the Steiners. That's my prediction, 1, 2, 3. Let's talk to the Steiners.
Right now, let's us take a look at the Ruse Move of the Week. The Ruse
News Move of the Week. This week features the U.S. heavyweight champion, the Total Package Lex Luger, as he battles with Ric Flair, the world champion. Now you'll be seeing a combination of athletic ability and strength as he demonstrates the superplex off the rope. The Ruse Move of the Week with Lex Luger. Ruse, shoes for your feet, pockets for your stuff.
Right here with the World Tag Team Champions, Rick and Scott Steiner. We just saw Doom in action, and I gotta say, they're looking pretty sharp, ready for that challenge on the titles, Rick.
Yeah, you know, Ron and Butch, they do look good, but who cares about that Teddy Long? What is he out there for? What is he good for?
He's out there to try to get in your hair and see if he can't put those belts around the waist of Doom.
That's all he's good for, is getting in the way.
He has made a flat-out prediction, Scott, that they are going to be the new World Tag Champions.
You know, Lance Russell, when me and my brother were growing up as kids, we had nothing. We didn't have the toys that other kids had to play with. We didn't do the things that other kids did. Then when we went to high school, there were people that doubted that we could be state champions. And then when we went to college, there were people that doubted that we could be All-Americans. And then when we turned pro, there were people that doubted us that we could be world champions. So, Doom, you want to be world champions? You want to jump on our backs? Well, you better get ready to be suplexed, because you're no different than everybody else that we wrestled. And get ready to go for a ride, because your trip to Washington, D.C. is one you'll want to forget. Hey, dude, come down to the dog pound and jump into the pit with the dog face and the wild thing and see what things are really all about. Well, you guys are going to get suplexed.
You'll be able to take them regardless of the fact they are a very big tag team.
They're a big team, but the bigger they are, the farther they fall.
Okay, you hear it from the Steiners. Looking forward to see him in action.
Making life a little sweeter. Making life a little sweeter.
Mars.
Making life a little sweeter.
But if I can stay alive.
Making dreams a little truer. Life a little sweeter.
What? You want to sit? Crazy dog.
All right, penguins. Make sure we're not wasting water.
Gotcha.
And rats, check that the house is properly insulated.
Aye.
And Bessie, make certain we're recycling all our bottles, cans, and paper.
Gee, Piggy, what can we do to help the environment?
Let's not waste electricity.
What? To find out what you can do to help, write to Make a Difference, National Wildlife Federation, Washington, D.C., 20036.
Lights out! Come here!
Next time on an all-new episode of Star Trek, The Next Generation.
What am I doing here?
Commander Data is held hostage by powerful aliens.
If I help you escape, will you take me with you?
Will he break free and survive his capture? Or will he face death trying to escape?
No life signs.
Find out on the next all-new episode of Star Trek, The Next Generation.
Tonight at 7 on WPTT-TV.
John Travolta is a sound effects specialist who witnesses a bizarre accident.
Look, let me tell you something. I was there. That tire was shot out. I heard it. I recorded it.
And saving the sole survivor sets off a killer's insane plan to eliminate the only witness.
I've decided to terminate her and make it look like one of a series of sex killings in the area.
A spine-tingling movie by Brian De Palma. Starring John Travolta, Nancy Allen, and John Lithgow. Blowout.
Tonight at 8 on WPTT-TV. Pittsburgh's 22.
Well, here it is. There this it is one of the moments we've been waiting for. The big major announcement coming up from the Horseman. Now, I gotta say, it was surprising up when Barry Windham came rolling back in as one of the
horsemen. But, brother, we got even a bigger surprise on the way. A pitcher tells a thousand words. As they say in Hollywood, roll it.
Yeah, well, what we're going to be looking for is something that takes place with Jimmy Cornette on the Louisville Slugger, and let's find out what that big announcement is.
Well, my guests have joined me in the ring, ladies and gentlemen, the leaders of the Four Horsemen, none other than Nature Boy Ric Flair, the six-time NWA World Heavyweight Champion, and of course, the spokesman of the Four Horsemen, Ole Anderson.
I tell you what, when you talk about wrestling, you talk about the Four Horsemen. People out here love the Horsemen, and I don't blame them. We brought out Arn Anderson. We brought out Barry Windham. Everybody said, what possibly could top that? Well, I'll tell you what, when it comes to surprises, there's nobody better than the Horsemen. We got one more big announcement to make, one more addition to the Horsemen, and we want to bring him out here right now. Take a look at the new Horsemen. You hear the music? You know who it is? Woman, come on out here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the newest member of the Four Horsemen of Professional Wrestling, accompanied to the ring by woman, 6'9", 320 pounds. He's the most awesome physical specimen in professional sports today. Sid Vicious. Oh, my. Only I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
Well, believe it. And I'll tell you one guy that's going to have a real hard time believing it. And that's going to be Lex Luger. And the next guy that's going to have a tough time is Sting. And the next guy that's going to have a tough time, well, wait a minute. She can tell you who's going to have a tough time. Go ahead.
Woman, it looks like your goals have finally been achieved.
Yes, Jasmine, that's right. And the manhunt is over.
Sid Vicious, I got a feeling you got one person on your mind.
I got one message for you, RoboCop. They say you're the man of the future. No, I'm the man of the future of the world, of the wrestling world, everything. I'm going to crush you like a tin can.
Ric Flair, Arn, Ole, Barry, Sid, the list is about that long now of horsemen. People continuously still asking me, Sting, what are you thinking? What are you doing? Five against you, not all the way back 100%, and then this tin man or whoever he is. Well, don't underestimate this guy, RoboCop, and don't underestimate me either, because if you had to put it in percentages and say, well, Sting, you're only 50%, think about it. What if I'm more like 90%, Rick? You know what I'm like at about 90%, don't you? You know what I'm like at 100%. 100%? I'm frightening to you. And I know that. I might be just very close to 100%. And the other thing about those odds, I'll just say this again. Everybody in Washington, D.C., when you look around like this, and you're backing up from RoboCop and Sting for God knows what reason, and you turn around to the people and say, oh, my God, I don't know what they're going to do, you won't get any help.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Making his way toward the ring from the City of Sunshine, weighing 238 pounds, Johnny Ace. In the ring, 278 pounds, Mark Kyle.
Well, I just gotta say, I can't believe it. Sid Vicious being added to the Horsemen. When is enough going to be enough for those guys?
I mean, you talk about monopolizing wrestling. Now they've, I mean, Barry Windham coming back to rejoin the Four Horsemen, unify what has been the supreme organization in wrestling, and then to go out and get 6'9" Sid Vicious. They're unstoppable. Their plan will come through. Goodbye, Sting. Goodbye, RoboCop 2. And goodbye, Capital Combat.
Yeah, you just kissed it all off very fast. I wouldn't say that it's going to be that easy for anybody. I gotta tell you, it surely looks like the deck is stacked in favor of the Horsemen. Chapman, with the addition of one Barry Windham and two giants Sid Vicious in their camp.
The way I see it, I think they're going to do exactly whatever they want to do. And if I was a horseman with that kind of power behind me, I'd do the same thing.
Okay, well, let's take a look in the ring right now as Mark Kyle takes the arm right at the wrist of Johnny Ace, turns it over, puts him on the rope, and hammers away with that right hand.
You know, I bet you would have never suspected Sid Vicious as a, four horseman.
I gotta be honest with you. You're right.
Well, never. See, that's why you should start. Listen to us. Good backward suplex by Johnny Ace. Took a man well over his size, lifted him up, and he got out of that headlock. But can he do that to Mark? Mean Mark. Let's make sure we emphasize that. Mean, heartbreaking Mark at Capital Combat 90 return of RoboCop.
He's got a week to think it over because he'll be flat meeting him come next week. Over the top and a big elbow on the dandy. This Mark Kyle is no flyweight.
No, he's not.
He's a big-sized guy, and you're taking a look at a kid that is really doing a number. Got him covered. One, two, three. He got the pin. Big win.
Here's your winner, Johnny.
Young man, and he ought to be. He did the number, and you talking about a tune-up. There was a dandy getting ready for Mean Mark as we get ready to take a look at the replay.
Well, let's take a look. He takes a reverse neck breaker, drives him straight through the mat for the 1-2-3, but I wonder about this. Will he be smiling like that in a week from tonight when his heart gets broke?
Okay, back in a moment with Animal and Mean Mark.
It's time for another WPTT-TV movie premiere. This time, travel back to the Old West with Doc and Marty in Back to the Future Part 3. There'll be Indians, bad guys, and lots of laughs. If you'd like tickets for a sneak preview of Back to the Future Part 3, send your name, address, and telephone number to Back to the Future, WPTT-TV, Post Office Box 2809, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 15230. The preview is set for Tuesday, May 22nd at 7:30. From your friends at WPTT-TV, Pittsburgh 22.
The Ultimate Contest. This week on American Gladiators, Round 2 Finals. Indianapolis's Lucian Anderson versus California's Elgin Kidd, and Illinois's Bridget Venturi versus LA's Wendy Brown. It all comes down to this match. Let the games begin. American Gladiators.
Tonight at 6 on Pittsburgh's 22.
Attention stereo and electronics consumers. Major manufacturers and distressful distributors are desperate for cash.
Sell it.
Name brands like Alpine, Kenwood, Sony, Pioneer, Yamaha, JVC. Prices have been drastically cut, up to 80%. Cordless phones with a 1,000-foot range from $44. CD players under $100. Home speakers from $10 each. AM/FM car stereo cassette deck from $19. 200-watt 6x9 three-way car speakers from $6 each. DJ mixers from $49. All merchandise fully warranted. No reasonable offer refused.
I just think it's a waste.
Just don't do it.
It's just plain stupid.
These messages are brought to you by WPTT, the Acura dealers of Western Pennsylvania and Mothers Against Drunk Driving.
Drinking and driving can kill.
Once I saw a movie, it started, I think, Mothers Against Drunk Driving. It was really sad. A drunk driver who just came back from a bar hit a girl, and her sister just kept on having nightmares. And that's when I got really scared about if I was walking home from my bus stop, if a drunk driver came and hit me, I don't know what I'd do. And my parents, they'd be in shock.
I think that None for the Road is a really good motto because it's really expressive.
None for the road.
None for the road.
Gentlemen from Chicago, Illinois, and the Legion of Doom, accompanied by Precious Paul Ellering, Road Warrior Animal.
Well, there it is. guys. What do you think of this? Road Warrior Animal and Mean Mark. Plus, we've got Teddy Long and Paul Ellering at ringside.
Well, I'll tell you what I think. Right off the bat, you got trouble here. And if anybody's got something to lose here, uh-oh. Push. Here they go.
Look at the Animal go right
after with a fist. That's what he gets. Ask and you'll receive. If Animal was to get hurt here, it would really, really kind of hurt the chances of the six-man tag with him and Hawk against Norman, Kevin Sullivan, Bam Bam Bigelow, and Cactus Jack. Look at that suplex.
Uh-oh. Unbelievable. Look at this. The Animal popped up. Drop kick from the big guy. Goes right in after Mean Mark. Pops him in and lays that shoulder to him. Hello, Mean Mark. Welcome to the Road Warriors.
I've been waiting for this match, Lance. Me and P.S. Hayes was talking about it, and Mean Mark and Animal in the same ring at the same time. The flesh is going to fly.
You know, Beans, we've got both managers out there that are both heavily involved by themselves in their own match, in the hair match at Capital Combat. I have to question both men's strategy, putting each one of their men in such a high pivotal match 1 week away.
Well, they do, in fact.
Could be a big mistake.
They have taken the choice to lay it on, and we got it on the pro, the whip into it. 360 power slam.
Beautiful power slam, but let's straighten something up. We didn't get it. We, Jimmy Jam, and I got this match for our show. You didn't have nothing to do with it.
No.
Pile driver, good night. That's it.
Look at this. He jumped right up. Say it now.
I don't believe it.
Nailed him on the clothesline, and Mean Mark.
Jimmy Jam, he jumped right up from that pile.
I think that would surprise BPS. I mean, I believe it. These two guys, you never know what they're going
to
do.
Well, it only goes to show, if you don't execute a move properly, then it doesn't have the same effect.
Oh, I see.
See, if we had done it, nothing against me, Mark, but, you know.
It wouldn't have anything to do with the fact that that is the legendary Animal of the Road Warriors. Maybe that just had something to do with it.
We would have had him beat already.
Oh, I see. Okay, down into the midsection.
But right now, Mean Mark has to beat him.
Hey, listen, coming up this week, I got to warn the people who normally call the profile on the 900 line, the fabulous Freebirds, and I got to tell you, I cannot believe it, will be on this Wednesday if you dial it up.
Yeah, our life story will be on there.
Oh, yeah. And you got to hear. Look at this. Here he comes.
Whoa, nobody home.
Nobody home is right.
High-risk maneuver, huh?
He went flying through that air and pounded over. Missed him and caught into the turnbuckles, but he's right back to work again.
You know what I wonder about? Now imagine it. What if he loaded up and hit Animal with that hard punch? I mean, it could not only, of course, cost him the match, and also probably cost him Capital Combat, but what about his career?
Well, in addition, I got to add one thing. Look at this. He started in too quick. He's maybe taking this Road Warrior too lightly. He's made two major mistakes, guys. Now, you got to admit, he's been in there too quick, and out of the ring he goes as Mean Mark grabbed a hold and flipped him out of there.
Hey, Paul Ellie, get out of the way now. Go outside interference.
Uh-oh.
He's on Mean Mark. It's all me, Mark, started running, Lance.
Ellering chasing Teddy Long around, and look at the Road Warrior. Slamming Mean Mark. Catches him with a clothesline. Puts him right down on the mat. Mean Mark now finding what it's like to have to pull himself back up and get in a match.
Where's the count? How about the count on the match?
That is Teddy Long.
Oh, no. This is uncalled for.
Goodness, what is he doing, P.S.?
Look at that. He hard punched him. I don't think he got all of it in it, but look, he put him down. I told you this would happen. I told you.
Outside of the ring, Mean Mark reached over, ripped in, pounded Animal.
And look,
now he's out on the floor, down on the side, and look in the ring at Paul Ellering going to work. Hey, what were you telling me about
it? He loaded it. Boom.
Oh, yeah.
Goodbye. He loaded that one.
He deserves it. He deserves everything. He had no business being in the ring in the first place.
He came in because Teddy Long got up there. Don't start that stuff pointing fingers.
Teddy Long was pulled into the ring by Animal. Look at the effect. Look at Paul Ellery. They are heartbroken. If he'd have loaded that thing, Animal would be doing just the same thing as Paul Ellery right now. Nothing.
Well, there it was. It ended up in a situation where Animal got a hold of him. We have got some kind of a battle brewing with these guys already. We're going to be back. We've still got Norman coming into the picture in a moment.
I am sick and tired of every time I look around, I see a contract with the Road Warriors name on it. Well, let me tell you something, Road Warriors. We have proven to the NWA, we have proven to all the people that the Road Warriors can be beat. We have beat them in every building and every arena that the Soul Brothers Doom have been signed with them. But no, they want to keep on coming back for more. Well, Road Warriors, we ain't running. So wherever it is, this is what's going to happen. Tell them, Butch.
Road Runners, prepare yourselves for defeat. We sat back and we watched Doom backstab the Steiners until the Steiners got revenge. Then Teddy Long gets rid of the Skyscrapers because we beat them up. The Road Warriors did. And then he gets Doom and pays for their services. Well, we got tired of you guys jumping in our face. So we're going anywhere we can across this country, no matter where it is. Doom, we want you. You want us. It's going to be the worst thing you've ever wanted.
You don't need a touch your shot. Tetris.
Have you been Tetrisized?
Square, rectangle, trapezoid, Tetrisoid.
Nintendo introduces Tetris.
Put a piece here, put a piece there.
Use your thumbs, use your eyes.
Find yourself Tetrisized.
Now you're playing with power.
Making life a little sweeter.
Right back and stay a while.
We tried this new restaurant. I had a miniature chicken.
Squab.
With a magnolia on the side.
Gardenia.
Tonight it's a sandwich and a smooth, mellow A&W cream soda. Nice centerpiece.
With a salad.
A&W cream soda. There's just more to it.
A famous doctor gives the miracle of life to childless couples.
I'm almost positive that there's a cursed object behind all this.
The price is the sacrifice of life itself.
I know I had twins. Where's my baby?
Now Mickey, Johnny, and Jack must save the innocent offspring of an ancient religious cult.
We need another sacrifice.
So the Druids can rise again.
On an all-new episode of Friday the 13th, the series.
Today at 5 on WPTT-TV. Next week on WPTT's 8 o'clock movies. Monday, William Shatner and Leonard Nimoy star in Star Trek The Motion Picture. Tuesday, Chuck Norris is driven by revenge in Forced Vengeance. Wednesday, Kirk Cameron and Dudley Moore star in the wacky comedy Like Father, Like Son. Thursday, Tom Skerritt strikes out against crime in Fighting Back. And Friday, Jan Michael Vincent takes on a vicious street gang in Defiance. Tune in for the 8 o'clock movies next week on WPTT-TV, Pittsburgh's 22.
All wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Making his way toward the ring from the State Hospital, weighing 384 pounds, Norman!
There he is, look at him! His special hula.
In the ring, 231 pounds, Mike Winner!
That's the contest as it's set up. Mike Winner going against very large Norman. And look at that get up on Norman today. You know, I still cannot get over the announcement by the Horseman that the newest member is going to be Sid Vicious.
Well, you better get over it. And I'll tell you, at least you're not Sting. At least you're not RoboCop, nuts and bolts. You don't have to worry about it. And at least you're not Lex Luger and have to figure out what is going on here. What's this, his son?
Well, no, Norman, that didn't, you got to put a little motion down below there, Norman.
Well, look how much there is down below to get motionated.
He wrestles like he hula hoops.
He's got a shaking baby, and now he's got a youngster from the side coming into the ring. Give him a little handshake. Says, okay, guy, show me. No, it didn't work. I think he's been taking lessons from Norman. I'm not sure, though.
I'll tell you what. Norman, you better get, I don't know who's directing you, but you better get your senses if you've got any in perspective, because a week from tonight, you're going to have Bam Bam Bigelow, Kevin Sullivan, and Cactus Jack, and I don't think they're going to be thinking about hula hooping.
Okay, the bell is off and running here. We're ready to go with Norman and Mike Winner. By the way, I haven't had a chance to really welcome you guys back from the T.J. Martell line.
Oh, you player. Just didn't want to admit that you knew we won the bowling tournament. We won it, didn't we, Jimmy?
We had a great time in Los Angeles. Let me tell you, we're going to have some films to show you about that, too, Lance.
Oh, are you?
Yes.
You're going to have some films?
Yes, we are.
Yeah. Good. Well, I'm looking forward to that big clothesline. And I mean, I'll tell you, when this guy, as big as he is at 384, puts the clothesline out, brother, you can hang a lot of body on it, and he just did. Headbutt, and Mike Winter goes down to the mat as Norman doing a number right here in our match on the NWA Pro. The fabulous Freebirds, Lance Russell, coming to you from Rainesville, Alabama, and a great crowd on hand.
Hey, when you say the fabulous Freebirds, don't forget the greatest rock and roll band of all time.
Oh, I'm sorry that I didn't mention it.
But listen to this. Can you imagine, much less the size of Sid Vicious, the size of Barry Windham, the size of the Four Horsemen as a unit. Sid Vicious has been out this long without getting a chance to beat on somebody. Can you imagine how long he's been waiting just to punch somebody in the mouth, just to knock somebody's lights out? And a week from tonight, he's going to get his chance, and he'll do it.
Wouldn't it be interesting if he happened to pick a RoboCop to start beating on? Look at Norman. He's giving him the whole new team, boy.
It's hard not to look at Norman. He takes up 90% of the screen.
And you never know what he's going to do. He's so unpredictable.
He don't know what he's going to do.
That's true. He don't.
Listen, who signed him up for our show?
I don't know.
I didn't do it. Did you do it?
No.
Lance.
Knock on it. Edition, night's edition in there is Norman tapping Mike Winter right in the face. He is unpredictable. One thing we can agree on is certainly that. As he brings Winter out to the center of the ring and clubs him with that forearm down to his knees. And Norman shovels him back, a whip in. Oh, the big elbow.
You know, as big as he is, he does move well. I mean, nothing like the Samoans, but can you imagine if he never was so sidetracked and distracted, how good he could be? Of course, that's an impossibility. Look at him. What's he braiding the guy's hair?
He got him tied up to the rope with his hair, and Mike Winter now trying to.
Oh, you think that's funny?
Norman's enjoying it. Oh,
yeah, because you got this L7 haircut, you know, square biz. Hair long enough.
If I was the referee, I'd have disqualified him.
I know
him.
You would have. I know you would have. And if you'd been that Mark Winter, you'd have just untied yourself and tied Norman up in a bunch of knots, and that's what's going to happen to him anyway.
Sound like you guys may be a little sensitive about Norman's activity.
We don't like him. He's disgusting. He stinks.
I never would have gathered
And he
that.
Can't dance.
That's right. Not at all.
Well, he hasn't had the proper music. He needs the rock and roll music of the fabulous Freebirds.
Now you're talking. Now
back
you're
into the ropes. And Mike Winter now starting to pound away with that knee to the midsection.
See. That's what happens when you get distracted and you don't capitalize. He had this kid beat 4 minutes ago, but no.
He's trying to hula hoop.
Yeah, hula hoop now, Norman. Look at that. Come on. Get that hula hoop now, Norman.
He peeled him right out of that corner and across the ring. And look at Winter coming in behind on Norman, the referee.
Looks a little bit like Steven Tyler of Aerosmith, who we've seen out at the T.J. Martell Rock and Roll.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, we just can't wait for those little pictures that are going to be coming up. Norman!
Wait.
Corner.
Who's that at ringside?
Is that Snake Brown down there?
Downtown Snake Brown, or is it uptown, or what town?
He don't know.
What in the world is he out
there? Doggone it, I know it. Him and Norman are brothers. Gotta be. They both got the same look in their eyes. Nothing.
Norman draped over the top rope, and yeah, that Snake Brown in the background. Many of you from the pro viewing in the past have seen the snake in action. Look, Norman shaking it off, saying, hey, try it. Let me have your best shot. Give me your best shot.
I'm telling you what, Snake Brown is...
I thought Norman was crazy. Take a look at that Snake Brown. That's a crazy fool for you now.
But Norman puts him down on the mat. Mike Winter now whipped across the ring into the rope.
Wow!
Shot!
Don't tell me Snake Brown is motivating Norman.
I don't know exactly what it is, but the snake is out there in the corner. And he was doing a little rain dance a moment ago. Big slam straight down on him. Norman, here he comes. He's using...
Move!
One of his... up the victory.
Here's your winner, Norman!
Right now, here's a look at the Nintendo Power Play.
Well, you know, I knew what was going to happen. Norman was setting him up there. You see him doing it. Oh, my goodness. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. 1, 2, 3.
Nintendo, now you're playing with power.
World Championship Wrestling's coming to Pittsburgh, Colombo Center, Friday, June 1st, 8 o'clock, a break night. The NWA World Championship, Lex Luger clashing with Nature Boy, Ric Flair. The Road Warriors take on Doom, Rick Steiner versus Barry Windham. Norman clashes with Bam Bam Bigelow. Plus an all-star card, Friday, June 1st at 8. Ticket information at the box office and the Colombo Center outlets. Yes, World Championship Wrestling in Pittsburgh.
This could be the ball game. Back to throw. He's got a man deep. Touchdown! What a leaping grab in the end zone. The defender can do nothing about it. We've got a tie ball game, and what a comeback. Less than a minute to go. Huh? Now the extra point kicks the lead. Here's the snap. Kick is up.
Making life a little sweeter. Making life a little sweeter.
Mars.
Making life a little sweeter.
My pocket stay wide.
Making dreams a little truer. Life a little sweeter.
Attention stereo and electronics consumers. Major manufacturers and distressful distributors are desperate for cash.
Sell it!
Name brands like Alpine, Kenwood, Sony, Pioneer, Yamaha, JVC. Prices have been drastically cut. Up to 80%. Complete car systems from $29. 200-watt 6x9 car speakers, $6 each. 200-watt car graphic equalizer from $19. Complete home systems from $69. Home speakers from $10 each. Microphones, telephones, headphones under $5. All merchandise, fully warranted. No reasonable offer refused.
One sure way to shake your blues, put yourself in someone else's shoes. It could take less time than to clean your room or do homework. Well, I bet you never, ever, never knew such a really cool thing to do. Could be so simple and so quick, that's it. Nominate yourself to be the most popular guy you'll ever see. It's much easier than multiplying fractions.
See you later, Dad. Thanks for signing my shoes.
Shoes?
That's it. Do something not for someone else, bit. That's it.
Hey, thanks.
They kind of needed it.
You're all right.
Have fun.
Doing something nice is doing something right. From the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Starting your engine's a terrible thing to do because at startup, oil's in the pan, not in the engine. Startup lubrication that lasts over 50,000 miles. Slick 50, the engine wear protect.
I'd rather switch than itch. So I switched to Tegrin Medicated Shampoo. It controls all major causes of itching and flaking.
Wouldn't you rather switch than itch?
Ultima Exodus is a challenge for the most experienced Nintendo game players. Control four fantasy characters in this ultimate role-playing adventure from FCI, not just kid stuff. Sugar Daddy. Some things never change. Sugar Daddy has the flavor which lasts a lifetime.
NWA Pro has been brought to you in part by the makers of A&W Root Beer and Cream Soda. So sit back and enjoy an A&W. There's just more to it. And by Nintendo Entertainment System. Nintendo, now you're playing with power. And by Rouge, shoes for your feet, pockets for your stuff. Well, I gotta tell you, we had a magnificent one today. How about that match with Animal and Mean Mark and the big announcement that we had coming out of the Horseman talking about Sid Vicious joining.
You know, they've been telling us about that all along. The Horsemen's told us what they were going to do, and they did it. They followed up on it with Sid Vicious, yeah. Barry Windham. Hey, they're going to be hard to stop, Lance. I'm telling you.
Jimmy, might I bring to your attention that when the match comes off with Flair and Luger,
They'll be in a cage, and there won't be anybody getting in.
Lance, would you answer the phone? Stop and smell the roses. Don't you understand why they bought Sid Vicious? Listen to me. He's going to rip the cage door off.
Not only that, he's going to take RoboCop's head and rip that off, too.
Well, there you hear it from the fabulous Freebirds. For Michael, PSA's Jimmy Jam Garvin. We're looking for you next week. Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.